Dijo alguna oportunidad.
Fidel Castro said on one occasion,
que se puede conocer a un pueblo en dependencia de cómo cuide a sus discapacitados.
That you get to know what people are like by the way that they treat the disabled.
Y nuestro José Martí, que es el apóstol de la Revolución Cubana.
And our José Martí, who is the apostle of our revolution.
Hablaba de la educación especial, es decir, para niños con dificultades.
Talked about special education for children with difficulties.
Como una de las cosas más importantes que tiene que enfrentar la sociedad.
As one of the most important things that society has to face.
Por suerte para los cubanos, no tenemos muchos problemas de autismo, por ejemplo.
Fortunately for us Cubans, we do not have many problems of autism.
Pero también tenemos niños con discapacidades en distinto grado.
But we do have children with disabilities of different grades.
Yo siento un orgullo extraordinario de decir que trabajo en una escuela de niños minusválidos en La Habana.
I'm very proud of the fact that I work also with a school for children with disabilities in Havana.
Realmente es un trabajo lindísimo.
It's actually a lovely job.
Y todos los compañeros que trabajan en esa escuela son personas extraordinarias.
And my comrades who work in that school are extraordinary people.
Hay mucho amor al tratar a estos niños.
There's a lot of love given to these children.
Y eso es fundamental.
And this is fundamental.
Tenemos que seguir trabajando en este aspecto.
We need to carry on working in this area.
Estamos con muchas investigaciones. Tenemos un gran centro de investigación neuronal en Cuba.
We have a
sistema nervioso central.
Nervous system, central nervous system. We have a lot of people working on this. We're trying to resolve a lot of these problems. And we're working quite seriously in this area.
Sin embargo, todavía nosotros en Cuba tenemos muchísimos problemas desde el punto de vista arquitectónico.
We have quite a lot of problems from the architectonic point of view.
Eso es un problema que hay que resolver.
That's a problem that we need to resolve.
Es decir, no todas las aceras en Cuba tienen para subir el silla de rueda, por ejemplo.
For example, not every pavement in Cuba has made arrangements so that you can actually wheelchairs up them.
Muchas de nuestras escuelas tienen escaleras, no tienen elevadores.
A lot of our schools have got staircases but no elevators.
Y eso limita un poco a los muchachos.
And this has limited effects.
Pero Cuba ha desarrollado mucho, por ejemplo, la parte del deporte en los minusválidos.
But Cuba has developed a lot of sports activities for disabled people.
Y tenemos campeones olímpicos.
And we've also got, of course, our participation in the Olympics.
Hay mucho todavía que hacer.
Disabled Olympics.
Just quickly, I mean, some teachers here have just come back from Cuba on a delegation and from the National Union of Teachers. So the person from the trade union might want to follow their lead, because when they went to Cuba they took with them 10 braille machines which were collected by them and bought from the Royal College for the Blind, and they took them to the Abel Santa Maria school in Havana for the children there, visually impaired and blind school in Havana. So there's things that people can do, and you know, it's a good example for all of us in terms of solidarity.
I'm Chris Barrett. What I want to say is that Che Guevara was the communist revolution. And to make a speech where you say it is, you know, crucial that we forget about differences, strive for unity is to suggest that progress can be made by reforms, by slow.
Could you get to the question? Struggle. Sorry.
I think that the question is, do you really think it helps Cuba to pretend that somehow there's no difference between hopeless reforms, which will never end capitalism, and the communist revolution, which will?
Okay, thank you. Next question.
Yeah. Defendim?
Pardon, kapatın.
Bilmiyorum.
Ne soracağım? Sen bir şey sorun.
Spor. Hayır, ne? Ne yapıyorsun? Giyirsin, çık da sana. Olmaz. Anlamadım o.
Si tú quedas en español, yo
puedo
hablar en español.
Es
simplemente su padre es por revolución, por comunista revolución. Él no es por reformismo. ¿Y qué manera usted ayuda esta cuestión si usted habla de reformismo, de cambios lentamente, porque estos efectos son futiles, useless, futile?
It's more important
to say that I have a lot of
Yo soy militante del Partido Comunista Cubano.
I'm a member of the Cuban Communist
Party. Nosotros hacemos la revolución en Cuba.
We make a revolution in Cuba. We make a revolution.
Pero no podemos hacer la revolución en otro lugar.
It's not our place to make a revolution in another country.
Así que tenemos que respetar lo que los pueblos decidan hacer.
We've got to respect the decisions that our countries make, particularly other countries.
A mí me gustaría que los procesos revolucionarios fueran mucho más rápidos.
I would prefer more rapid revolutionary processes.
Me gustaría, por ejemplo, que en América Latina, todos los países latinoamericanos tuvieran un sistema socialista. Y estamos luchando todo el tiempo para despertar la conciencia social de la gente.
We're always working to arouse the social consciousness of people.
Pero la decisión es de ellos.
But the decision belongs to them.
Nosotros solo podemos apoyar a esos pueblos.
We can only support other people.
Y tenemos que respetar su decisión.
And we have to respect their decision.
No podemos imponernos.
We can't impose anything.
Es el respeto a los pueblos.
That's the respect for other countries, other people.
Aunque mi deseo sería mucho más diferente.
Of course, I have a different perspective.
Yes. Yes.
Benefited from working and studying in Cuba. So I actually was part of your revolution in terms of learning certain things about it. I benefited from your from your medical system as well. In the Caribbean, we also got a lot of support medically from Cuba. Is there any plans to do any expansion of that program in those countries?
A ver, nosotros creamos el ALBA.
We created the ALBA.
El ALBA es la Alternativa Bolivariana para nuestra América.
The ALBA is the Bolivarian Alternative for our America.
Y ahí está Cuba,
Venezuela, there is Cuba, Venezuela,
Nicaragua,
Nicaragua,
Ecuador,
Ecuador,
Bolivia,
Bolivia,
y dos pequeñas islas del Caribe.
And two small islands from the Caribbean.
Quisiéramos que todas las demás islas del Caribe se unieran al ALBA.
We would very much like it if all the other islands of the Caribbean were to unite themselves to ALBA.
Pero no todas son independientes.
But they're not all free.
Por ejemplo, Puerto Rico.
Puerto Rico.
Es un pueblo hermano de Cuba.
It's a brother people of Cuba.
Ahora mismo nosotros estamos sufriendo la ansiedad de no poder ayudarlo.
At the moment we're suffering the anxiety of not being able to help them. They've just had the Hurricane Maria.
Y todavía hoy la población de Puerto Rico tiene solamente 10% de electricidad.
And still now, they've only got 10% of electricity.
Y nosotros podemos ayudar a ese pueblo.
We could help the Puerto Ricans.
Tenemos los recursos nuestros para dárselos.
We've got the resources.
Pero el gobierno de Estados Unidos no lo permite.
The United States won't allow it.
Nos pasa lo mismo, por ejemplo, con Guadalupe, con Martinica.
With Guadalupe and Martinique, the same thing happened.
Son territorios de ultramar de Francia.
They're overseas territories of France.
Entonces no nos permite trabajar como pueblos hermanos.
They won't let us work there either.
Nosotros quisiéramos poder hacer mucho más.
We would like to do much more.
Pero económicamente tampoco es posible para Cuba.
But economically, it also isn't possible for Cuba.
Ahora solamente tenemos a los países que forman el ALBA estudiando gratuitamente en Cuba.
Now we've only got the countries that study from the ALBA working in Cuba.
No podemos extenderlo ahora más.
We can't at this point extend it further.
Porque económicamente no es posible.
Because economically it's not possible.
Pero en cuanto nos recuperemos un poco,
in the moment we recuperate a bit,
seguramente vamos a volver a abrir.
We'll be able to open things up again.
Bye bye.
We'll see.
To say that while you spoke of the incredible internationalist achievements in healthcare, last month NHS England has introduced passport checks for secondary tier, so non-emergency healthcare, where people will now be denied healthcare in Britain, and that's antenatal care, paediatrics, cancer care. So you are right, we have a lot of work to do here. And viva Cuba!
We can stick to questions.
England is quite a rich country, and yet we don't even train enough doctors to look after the people within the borders of England. How can we encourage England to actually export medical care, to train more doctors in England, so we have more to share, instead of exporting military arms?
A ver, la primera pregunta.
The blockade does hurt the Cuban health system.
Porque la tecnología, por ejemplo, es muy difícil de adquirir.
Because the technology is very difficult to obtain.
En mi hospital, nosotros hemos usado un rayo X, un aparato rayo X, por más de 45 años.
In my hospital, we've used an X-ray machine for more than 45 years.
Y le sacamos todo lo que podíamos sacar del aparato.
And we really exploited this machine.
Ahora tenemos uno nuevo.
We've now got a new one.
Pero nos ha costado muchísimo comprarlo.
But it's cost us a lot to purchase it.
Primero porque no lo vamos a hacer directamente a la empresa que lo produce.
First of all, because we can't buy it directly from the company that produces it.
A veces tenemos que tener tres, cuatro intermediarios.
There are times when we need two, three intermediaries.
Ya es caro de por sí. Ahora imagínate con todos esos intermediarios cómo se encarece.
And that's expensive as it is. And you can imagine how much dearer it becomes with all these intermediaries.
También hemos tenido que aprender a restringir más ese tipo de acción en la medicina.
We've also had to learn how to restrict more this type of thing in that medicine.
Y desarrollar más la clínica médico.
And to develop more the clinics.
Es decir, ver, oler,
see, smell,
y palpar,
and touch.
Es muy importante para nosotros hacer una buena clínica.
It's rather important for us to make an important clinic.
Y usar estas cosas ultramodernas en última instancia.
And to use these ultra-modern things where possible.
Tenemos ahora toda la tecnología.
We now have all the technology.
Pero realmente es muy difícil para Cuba adquirirla.
It's actually very difficult for Cuba to obtain it.
Por eso hay que cuidarla mucho.
That's why we have to look after it a lot.
Igual pasa con los medicamentos.
The same thing happens with medicaments.
Hay una organización europea que se llama Medicuba Europa.
There's a organization called Medicuba Europe.
Que empezó por Medicuba Suiza.
It started through Medicuba Switzerland.
Y realmente le debemos a esa organización muchísimo de las posibilidades que hoy tenemos.
And we owe that organization many of the possibilities that today we have.
Ellos compran, por ejemplo, materia prima y la envían a Cuba para que nosotros podamos fabricar nuestros medicamentos.
We obtain primary materials through them, so that we can then manufacture our medications.
Por ejemplo, ustedes usan muchas veces el ibuprofeno a 600 miligramos.
You use
ibuprofen.
A 600 miligramos.
At 600 milligrams.
Nosotros lo fabricamos de 200 y es suficiente.
We produce it at 200 milligrams and it's sufficient.
Y nos da para muchas más dosis.
And it gives us many, many more dosages. Protects the stomach.
Pero de verdad que nos afecta mucho el
bloqueo. I have to say that we're really affected by the blockade.
Hemos tenido casos muy duros.
We've had some rather severe cases.
Por ejemplo, un niño de 5 años con una meningoencefalitis herpética.
A child of 5 years old with.
Y el medicamento específico para esta patología es de Estados Unidos, patentes de Estados Unidos.
And the specific patent for this medication is in the United States.
Nosotros pedimos el medicamento.
We asked for the medication.
No nos lo dieron.
They wouldn't give it to us.
Las organizaciones de solidaridad en Estados Unidos, que son muchas organizaciones por Cuba.
There are a lot of solidarity organizations in the United States.
Compraron el medicamento.
Bought the medication.
Pero en la aduana se los retiraban.
But they would confiscate it at the the customs.
El cónsul de Argentina que estaba saliendo en ese momento de Estados Unidos.
The Argentinian consul who was leaving was leaving the United States at that point.
Se enteró de esto y él mismo metió el medicamento en su traje y lo trasladó.
And the Argentine consul simply put the medication into his suit.
Pero cuando llegó el medicamento a nosotros ya era tarde para el niño.
By the time the Argentinian consul got the medication to the child in Cuba, it was too late.
Y así hemos sufrido eso en muchas familias cubanas.
And we've suffered that in a lot of Cuban families.
Por eso decimos que es ahí donde más nos golpea el bloqueo.
That's where I think the blockade really hits us